had throughout this season. Getting ready to cheer on UNCW Senior Day, final game of the regular season. Anthony Franklin in between Boggs and Hannah. Tipped by Hannah, controlled by the Phoenix, and we're underway here inside Trask Coliseum. Right to left for Elon, out front Hannah, near sideline Burford. A touch for the freshman, trying to cross over, drives it right into the paint, flips up a shot, and it rattles home. Darius Burford, this week's player and rookie of the week, gets his scoring started for Elon. UNCW's first offensive possession, shooting at the goal to our right. Okaru bounce pass to Gadsden on the wing, back out front to Okaru. Skips it across the floor, Pridgen. Shot fake at the arc, trying to drive in, and he travels with it right in front of the Elon bench. As you see, Mike Schrage there, the second-year head coach. He's got a young team the last couple of years, but young talent, including Hunter McIntosh, last year's rookie of the year.
Seahawks pick it up, full court pressure.
It is Okaru. Applying the pressure on it, Naduba. Get it to Hannah, out front to McIntosh, near sideline Burford. In the corner, he drives inside, hangs the shot up and in. And a couple of baskets here for Burford. 4-0 Elon, almost a minute in. Okaru out front, man-to-man defense for the Phoenix, knocked away and stolen now by Naduba. Naduba's layup off the glass, good, and Siddle has to call a quick timeout here for UNCW. As it has been Elon, the quick start. Marty, you mentioned this, their game against William & Mary, a quick start there for Elon, and a quick start here, up 6-0, 18-54 in the first half.
Yeah, you just really have to avoid that. Right now, you mentioned the word quick. Elon's the quicker team right now. You can see it. They're springing their step. They look fresher. Seahawks look like it's the first time they've been on the floor for a while. A little tentative, and again, a lot of the combinations are different. You've mentioned Elon's won 4 of the last 5 of this series. The only Seahawk victory was a CAA tournament victory. So they've won the last 4 regular season matchups, including, obviously, 2 here at Trask.
UNCW's ball out of the timeout. Okaru and the Seahawks set up, down 6-0. Okaru drives in, right corner Pridgen, feet set, 3 on the way is short, and rebound tracked down by Burford. Brings it down near sideline Okaru, man-to-man for UNCW. On a switch now it's Pridgen. Right, the handoff, far sideline to McIntosh. Burford, they work it near sideline. Naduba gets a screen, goes right to the wing, out front Burford. Trying to make a move on Pridgen, drives in, kicks it right corner. 3 on the way for McIntosh, is good in the corner. Hunter McIntosh knocks in the first point tonight from long range. 9-0 Elon. Harvey on the near sideline, gives to Gadsden. Gadsden, bounce pass near sideline to Okaru. Drives it in, left corner to Pridgen. 14 on the shot clock, he'll back it away to Harvey. Taps his head with his left hand. Burford defends, Boggs sets a screen, Harvey drives it right, knocked out of his hands, picked by Burford. Burford on the break, layup with the left hand off the glass, good. Darius Burford with 6 points here in the first couple of minutes, 11-0 Elon. Gadsden, far sideline to Okaru. UNCW started practice again on Sunday with just 7 players. A lot of coaches getting some work, driving in Okaru. Hangs, it gets fouled by Wright. First foul on Simon Wright, the first on Elon as well.
So on the last time down the floor before this possession that draws the foul, we saw with only 5 seconds left on the shot clock, you know, just what you're going to see today, some matchup issues where on that case, Harvey had the ball almost at midfloor, unable to run the offense yet, not the matchup you want, another steal, another turnover, but that's what you're going to have to work through today.
A little bit short, the first free throw attempt for Okaru. Averaging almost 15 points a game in conference play. That's bumped up to 20 points a contest. Connects there. He had a career-high 30 points last outing, January 31st against Hofstra. 11-1 our score, UNCW down 17-19. They apply some pressure in the backcourt. Bring it over. Lob pass to McIntosh, and he'll set it up. Gaston defends. Popping out to get it, it's Hannah. Top of the key. Looks off right, now gets on the right wing to McIntosh. McIntosh steps back, 3 is on net for Hunter McIntosh. McIntosh, 15 points in this building last year. actually at home against the Seahawks last year at 15. 14-1 our score here. Okoro hangs his shot short, tipped out, picked up by Burford. Burford drives in, hangs, banks it in, and gets fouled as well by the freshman Harvey.
So Mike, Elon has scored on every one of their offensive possessions, and now an opportunity for a three-point play as Burford's just been explosive, leading the break, taking advantage of the one-on-one situation. A couple substitutions right now for the shorthanded Seahawks. 16-1 run to open this one, exactly what UNCW had to avoid.
And Burford connects to complete the three-point play. He already has 9 points in this game. Had 27 last week, 13 earlier this week against William Marion. Off to a very hot start here. 17-1 our score. Elon in control. 16:31 to go. And we see Shaquem Phillips on the floor for the first time this season. Gadsden three is no good. And a foul on the floor as Amanjay Dodd gets fouled. And this foul goes against Chuck Hanna. So, you know, you get Shaquem Phillips back for the first time this season for UNCW. Amanjay Dodd. And then it is Jack Mertens, the other Seahawk available. The eight Seahawks. That is it in this game. Quickly into Harvey. Harvey jump shot left baseline. Around and out, but he's fouled. Fouled by McIntosh, the first on McIntosh. Now three team fouls here for Elon.
So, at the beginning of this contest, both teams really are thrilled that they're on the court today because Elon's had a down period. They've had games shuffled around. Of course, UNCW has not been on the floor for 20-some days. The last thing both of these teams wanted to do was have another weekend off heading into that CAA tournament. As you mentioned, so many teams on pause, including Charleston, who was scheduled to play back-to-back with UNCW this week before their COVID issue.
Harvey connects for the free throw line, makes good with 2:17-3 now our score, 16:21 to go in the first half here. Elon out ahead, some pressure on, broken by the Phoenix. Burford has it on the right wing. He'll set it up, trying to get it to Hannah. He does on a bounce pass out front. Backs it away. Naduba drives left, kicks it out. Burford. Burford three on the way, rattles home.
He can do no wrong.
Not so far this game. 12 points. Burford, a perfect 5-for-5 for the field. Makes it 20-3. He is pumped up. Out front defending Phillips. Shaquem Phillips angles it left, drives it in, stuck, spins, kicks it out to Gadsden. Gadsden back to Phillips. Phillips will drive, hangs in the air. The bank shot no good. Rebound Dodd brought it down and gets fouled in traffic. And another foul on Elon. That'll be on Burford. It looks like his first, team's fourth, as we head to our Reeves Jewelers timeout. 15:37 to go in the first half. Elon early control this one up 20-3. It's UNCW basketball and Flow Sports and the Breeze.
Short on cash? Have unwanted gold or silver? Bring it to Pawn USA. We're North Carolina's premier gold and silver buyer since 1980. Pawn USA will give you the best price in town on your gold, silver, or jewelry. You'll also save money on our wide selection of merchandise, including jewelry, electronics, tools, guns, musical instruments, and more. Don't forget, we cash payroll and income tax refund checks and have millions to lend for most items of value. Don't let life get you down. Get the money you need when you need it at Pawn USA, where the customer is always treated like family and the service speaks for itself.
Kennedy's Real Estate Services wants to help you with your real estate needs. Tim Kennedy has been your friendly neighbor for years, serving New Hanover, Pender, and Brunswick counties since 1994. Tim is a full-service broker which can help you find a home or sell your home, management services such as association management as well as long-term rentals. He is also a state-certified appraiser. He's on the web at CANADYRES.com or give him a call at 799-1068.
Ice Cold Bud Light. Bud Light Seltzer here. Bay windows, got two nice tuck pointing here. Retractable awning here, like it. Got the nice edging on the grass here. Edge the grass nice here. Ice cold Bud Light. Bud Light Seltzer here. Got a white breasted nut hatch here. Get your ice cold Bud Light. Bud Light Seltzer here. Bay windows, got two nice tuck pointing here. Retractable awning here, like it. Got the nice edging on the grass here. Edge the grass nice here. Ice cold Bud Light. Bud Light Seltzer here. Got a white breasted nut hatch here.
15:37 to go in the first half. UNCW trails 20-3. I'm Ajay Don at the free throw line. Mike DeCarroll, Marty Fuhr with you. And, well, it's been struggles for UNCW as the free throw is no good. The Seahawks, Marty, have not made a shot from the field. They're 0 for 4, while it's perfection right now for the Phoenix.
8 for 8, including 3 for 3 from 3. And Golden from the line, 1 for 1. Dodd 0 for 2, so all the Seahawk points, all 3, coming from the free throw stripe. A little pressure here.
Trying to break it. They do with a bounce pass to McIntosh. Burford near sideline. Extra pass to right and left corner. Up the sideline back to Burford. 20-3 Elon. Hannah gets it. Far sideline now to Burford. 5 on the shot clock. Naduba pulls up from 15. The shot in and out. The first miss for the Phoenix. And a rebound for Boggs.
Take him out.
Head to Phillips on the far sideline. Top of the key. Flips it now to Harvey. Hand off to Okaru. Near sideline to Phillips.
Seahawks trying to run the offense.
Phillips drives. Stuck at the free throw line. Leans in and gets fouled. So another trip to the stripe here for UNCW. Naduba picks up his first. It'll be the fifth team foul for Elon. UNCW, they have just one foul. And that's something that Takeo Siddle has to keep an eye on. With only 8 players available, he does not want to see his team get in any kind of foul trouble.
Phillips goes hard to the floor. As you made mention, his first appearance this year.
And the first free throw is good. On the all-rookie team last year, the sophomore from Winterville, North Carolina, out of South Central High School. Last year averaged almost 10 points, more than 2 assists a game as well. And really became the leader of this team once he took over as the point guard and did a great job. He did not play against Elon here in this building last year, and that was part of the setback for UNCW. He was playing so well at that time and was out with an injury. So he hits 1 of 2, makes it 20-4. UNCW trails 14-38. Hunter Woods into the game for the first time, has the top of the key, moves it right into the paint. Kicks it near sideline to McIntosh. McIntosh, another 3. Off balance, one-leg shot. No problem, says Hunter McIntosh. He's got 9 points on 3 threes. Makes it 23-4, Elon. Okaru to Boggs on the left wing. 14-15 left in the first half. Boggs gets it away to Harvey. Harvey 3, left side, all net for the freshman in the first field goal of the game for UNCW.
First field goal comes almost 6 minutes in. See if they can little victories in this first half. See if they can put together a couple of good back-to-back possessions.
Nice crossover move for Burford. The shot no good. Contested by Boggs, who comes away with the board. Boggs down the far sideline. How about a 3? Gets it out instead to Okaru. Dodd, Harvey. Phillips round out the 5. Driving in with a right hand. The layup off the glass goes through for Mike Okaru. 23-9 now, UNCW trails 13-31 in the first frame. Phillips almost poked that ball away from McIntosh. McIntosh spins and gives it off on the bounce pass to Hannah. Left corner to Woods. Hunter Woods shot fake, drives the baseline. Good recovery by the defense. A kick out to McIntosh, another 3, this time short, but Woods the rebound. Dumps it down low to Hannah. Hannah banks it in from the left side. Hunter Woods, team's leading rebounder, almost 7 a game, 5th best in the conference, and a big rebound. The feed to Hannah makes it 25-9.
And you can see Elon's advantage once they get deep into the paint around the boards.
Harvey, a corner 3 is short. Dodd over the back, and will be whistled for a personal foul. The first foul on Amaje Dodd, a sophomore from Snow Hill, North Carolina. UNCW second as a team.
So points in the paint early on, and in fact points off of offensive rebounds for Elon. They've picked up 6, doing a good job, obviously making the penetration off the drive.
UNCW will apply some pressure as McIntosh gets it over the stripe with a pass from Woods. Back to Woods near sideline. The handoff to Wooten. Checks in for the first time. Chris Wooten. Burford, right of the paint. Three on the way is an air ball way short for Wooten, and the Seahawks will get the ball back. So a couple of subs here, and the Elon team a little bit deeper than UNCW. Michael Graham on the floor for the first time, freshman from Brooklyn. 12:21 to go in the first. UNCW trails 25-9. With the basketball, the Seahawks get it out front to Gadsden. Now to Harvey. Going left off the screen from Boggs. As Karu drives it, steps through, off the glass, too hard. But in traffic, bodies get tangled up. And a whistle and a foul coming once again on Elon, it looks like. And Hunter McIntosh, that'll be number two on McIntosh, the sophomore guard from Georgia. Get a look at the replay here. So UNCW maintains possession, the 16 foul for Elon. 12:06 to go, McIntosh to the bench for the Phoenix. Into Harvey. And falls down, gets it right back. He's open for a three, no good. Rebound the hands of Graham. Down the floor, far sideline, Naduba. Graduate transfer from Bryant. Played 94 games for the Bulldogs there. Wooten, corner three. Much better for him than the one out on the wing. As Wooten connects, the junior from Kinston makes it 28-9, Elon.
Elon 5-for-7 from beyond the arc.
Crossing over, driving in. Gadsden, the shot no good. He hits the deck. Rebound brought away by Naduba. Burford, top of the key. On the dribble, moves it down low. Nice pass and a dunk for Michael Graham on the feed from Burford. 30-9, Elon. 11:14 to go in the first half. The Seahawks try to slow it down. We talked about the pushing the pace, but it's Elon pushing the pace here. And not UNCW. Okaru, left block, shot short. Rebound, Elon. Elon's a team last in the league. They average 64 points a game. But on a really big pace here as the ball is kicked by Pridgen. It'll stay with the Phoenix and bring us to a media timeout. 10:53 to go. We're in the first half. UNCW trying to keep pace right now with the Phoenix. Elon up 30-9. Back in a moment, UNCW basketball on Flow Sports and the Breeze.
As media and advertising continues to evolve, your business advertising needs to evolve with it. Sunrise Broadcasting will help you coordinate between all the different media platforms and deliver a hyper-effective, brand-building, customer-generating program all in one. Sunrise Broadcasting, your one-stop shop for results. For information, call General Manager Valerie Brooks at 910-632-2114.
Again.
910-632-2114.
There is something indescribably special about this place. The way it looks, the way it feels, the way we care for one another and our community. The University of North Carolina Wilmington is like no other.
You can't know someone has COVID-19 just by looking at them. Anyone can get it. But while you can't know who is carrying the virus, you should know that everyone who wears a mask has a reason to fight it. Whatever your reason, get behind the mask.
10:53 to go in the first half. UNCW trails 30-9. The offense has been tough going, but Mike Okoro trying to do his part. He's got 3 points right now. The Seahawks on the defensive end, though, coming out of the timeout. Burford has it out front. UNCW stays man-to-man. Burford, top of the key, stutter dribble, drives it right, hangs in the air. The bank shot too hard, but the putback, no good. And another try, Graham connects. So Michael Graham, 6'8", the freshman. An offensive putback to make it 32-9.
Elon, 16 points in the paint, 12 off of offensive rebounds.
Bridgen near sideline. Now out front to Dodd. Gets it away to Gadsden. Gadsden will drop the baseline, steps back, jump shot, connects. Ty Gadsden, one of the seniors recognized prior to the game, gets his first points of this contest to make it 32-11.
So individually, coaching staff just wants to see these guys get into rhythm a little bit.
Out front, controlled by Burford for Elon. They run a Princeton-style offense, so you can see the back cuts in trying to make this defense work. Get it down low to Graham on the feet to Burford. The shot is no good. Good defense that time for UNCW. Okoro right side to Phillips. Backs it away to Pridgen. Pridgen will drive in, leans in. A little push off as well. The bank shot is good for Joe Pridgen as he scores for the first time to make it 32-13. UNCW trails, 9:30 left in the first half.
And in many ways, that's his signature shot this year. Able to drive and use that big body to create some space. Now a hold out front.
Nikeem Phillips, his first, team's third.
Another look at the replay. Right there, lower the shoulder just a little bit. Use the glass.
He's 6'5", but 210, a stocky body. And used it well to his advantage there to Joe Pridgen, the Holy Cross transfer.
So Phillips will check out. We'll watch how many minutes he has on the floor his first day back.
So far, 5 minutes in this one as Woods spots up from three in the corner, and it's on it for the lefty, Hunter Woods, sophomore from Pasadena. Also on the all-rookie team last year, preseason honorable mention all-conference this year. Gadsden looking to answer, and he does. A two for Ty Gadsden. 35-15, the lead 20. It was 23, the largest of this first half so far in favor of Elon. 9 minutes to go in the first half. Burford on the left wing. Stutters, goes right top of the key. Looks back door instead out front to Woods. Woods cannot penetrate. Gives to right. Inside Graham. He fumbled with it. Knocked away and stolen by Gadsden. Oh, right goes down hard. He's hurt. The other way, it's going to be a blocking foul. Count for bucket for Pridgen. But Wright is down in some pain on his stomach.
And the officials are going to take a look at this on the replay as he got a shot. I don't know if it was an elbow way across the bridge of the nose, and he went down hard. And the officials will now take a look at the replay to see if there should be a flagrant foul as the trailer.
Get a look at the replay here.
There's ball a good defensive low. Stop. Now watch right hand, and we miss it. Right hand corner of the screen, almost directly in front of our broadcast location. Well, I should say mine. You're down at the baseline.
Yeah, the officials, see Anthony Franklin and then Jeremy Mosier over there to take a look at it and see if there should be anything added to this. Doesn't look like it. 35-17, 8:34 to go. UNCW trail. So on the other end, it was a bucket for Pridgen, and he was fouled by Naduba. Second foul on Naduba. 17 foul for Elon.
So, Mike, we've talked about it several times. So your score is 35-17. Right now, if you're the coaching staff, if you're the players on the floor, you want to play this game in segments now. You're coming out of a timeout. Let's put together a strong 2-4-minute break until the next timeout. Don't worry about the overall score. Just execute.
Good point there. Just a little bit at a time right now when you paint yourself into a corner to start this game. So Pridgen looking to complete the three-point play. Comes up short with it. Ball loose and tracked down by Elon in the corner. That's Naduba. 8:27 to go until halftime. 35-17 Elon. Hunter Woods Right side deflected out of bounds by Okaru. And Okaru, those quick hands, he is second in the conference, almost two steals a game. And we see the deflection there for the senior out of Raleigh, a guy who I think his head coach would like to see him consider coming back for another senior season, especially the way he is playing right now. Out front, Naduba spots up 15, too hard, and Okaru right there to get the rebound. Push ahead of Gaston, spots up three from the right wing, too hard there. And a rebound for Elon. 35-17 still the score. UNCW trails 8 minutes in the first half.
But you can see the Seahawks have their game legs all of a sudden. A lot quicker, more resistance at the defensive end, or the good pass, entry pass, and the slam at one end to Elon to push it out to 20. But just in the last couple of minutes, you can just see more flow, more energy from the Seahawks at both ends.
Elon took advantage of the mismatch there. Green with a dunk, 6'8", guarded by 6'1", Gadsden. Down low, Pridgen on the block, spins up and under off the glass, and it's good for Joe Pridgen, 37-19. So UNCW starting to answer now. They're five for their last six from the field here, shooting 41% overall, 65% though for Elon. Burford being chested up by Gadsden on the right wing. Graham sets a screen. Burford will drive, spins back. Near sideline, Wooten, a three for the wing. Bounces up, no good. And a rebound brought away for Boggs and the Seahawks. Pridgen fakes a pass. Hands on the right wing. He'll back it away to Gadsden. Hands here of Okaru. 6:48 in the first half. 37-19, the Seahawks trail. Oh, a nice pick and go. Layup good. And another foul as Pridgen got the feed from Harvey. And Pridgen, another chance of a three-point play. And he'll have that opportunity when we return from a timeout. A nice job here. You see the screen. You see him slip to the basket on the nice feed. The Seahawks down 37-21, 6:42 to go. Back in a moment. UNCW basketball and Flow Sports and the Breeze.
Dr. Christopher Branco of Oleander Chiropractic wants you to know that you don't have to be a UNCW athlete to be treated like one. Stop by Oleander Chiropractic on Oleander Drive in the Arboretum behind Port City Java, and you'll get the best care in a safe, comfortable family atmosphere. Dr. Branco has 15 years experience and is the official chiropractic consultant of UNCW Athletics. Oleander Chiropractic is open Monday through Friday with morning and evening appointments available. Most insurances accepted. For help, tips, and coupons, visit Oleander Chiropractic.com. Hampton Inn University and Hampton Inn and Suites Landfall Park are proud UNCW Seahawks sponsors. Award-winning hotels providing rooms, suites, catering, and meeting rooms. Ask for the Seahawks special. Call 910-509-0005. That's 910-509-0005 or HamptonInn.com and support the Seahawks.
Because of this, we built Ford Super Duty to be our most capable heavy-duty pickup. Because of this, we gave the all-new 2021 F-150 an available 12-inch touchscreen. Because of this, we built Ranger with a terrain management system. And because Ford trucks are built for this, you made Ford America's best-selling brand. Don't miss the chance to get a 2020 F-150 with up to $10,531 in total savings at your Carolina Ford dealer.
Randy 612 writes, if you like boneless wings, you dirty. Thanks for the input, Rand Man. But B-Dubs completely reinvented their boneless wings. First, they packed them with so much meat, vegans are writing letters, and I've got the meat sweats. Then they marinated them until they're so juicy it doesn't make sense anymore. Hey, poster boy, your basement isn't going anywhere. So get to B-Dubs for the new boneless wings. Buffalo Wild Wings. Roar!
6:42 left in the first. UNCW down 37-21. Marty, the Seahawks offensively getting things going a little bit more now. Six for their last seven, and they have settled into this game. And again, 27 days off. It takes you a little while to get that rust off and get back to basketball.
Yeah, you can feel you can see the running of the offense. You know, since that 17-1 opening, basically this game's been even. They've traded baskets. Seahawks now cut the lead. to 15.
Yeah, 37-22, 6:39 to go as Pridgen completes a three-point play for UNCW. Seahawks pressing, coming out of the timeout. Burford out front to Nduba. Nduba between the circles, defended by Harvey, still man-to-man for UNCW. Woods on the near sideline. Out front, Nduba deflected pass right back to him by Boggs. Driving in now, off an awkward shot, no good. And a rebound for Boggs to Harvey. The pitch ahead of Gadsden. Down low, Pridgen. Pridgen is good. Once again, down low off the glass. He's got 11 to lead UNCW right now. And the Seahawks within 13, down 37-24. 6 minutes to go in the first half.
And it's all started at the defensive end where the last couple of times down the floor, you can see shots have been contested, blocked. Another contest here.
Hosier's shot no good. Ball still loose. Battle for it. And Boggs saves it into Pridgen near sideline to Okaru. Okaru drives all the way in. Okaru off the glass, and the Seahawks on a run. Down 37-26, 5:38 to go, and Mike Schrage forced to call a timeout here, Marty.
Great energy, as we made mention. You know, you just want those small windows, play well, and right now the Seahawks are the more aggressive team. You can see they're running the offense. But Mike, at the defensive end, they're contesting passes, contesting shots. Here's a good look. Double team. Change the shot. Backside won't go. Keep it alive. On the baseline. Nice Boggs. Play by Boggs there. And all of a sudden you're down the floor running. And it's been the Seahawks that have been able to get the penetration. Good entry passes down low. And it's been a strong run.
Yeah, 13-2 run for UNCW. The last 3:27. Flip side, a scoring drought of more than 2 minutes for Elon. So UNCW down by 11, 5:38 to go. You see some of the students here taking in this action, and you've got to think that gives UNCW a little bit of a lift. Maybe just what they need, and near steal as Woods and Ty Gadsden both collide. It's going to be a foul on Gadsden, and Woods seems to have taken the worst of that. The first on Gadsden, the fourth on UNCW is Hunter Woods. Slow to get to his feet.
Yeah, he took a shot. Inadvertent, but both players going for the loose ball. Banged heads. Only the fourth team foul. Watch it right here. I'll tell you what, it was a tough pass that that left his teammate out to drive there. It's almost like a quarterback that leaves the receiver. You know, it's an incomplete pass, but the receiver paid the price.
Yeah, him and his quarterback talking to each other back in the huddle, right? McIntosh back on the floor here for Elon despite two personal fouls.
See if they can get another stop.
Fade away, tough shot for Woods is no good. Another good contest by Boggs. Rebound Pridgen ahead to Okaru. Okaru drives in. Right corner Boggs. Boggs stepped out of bounds as he had that foot, little jab step, then step back trying to drive, and he stepped on the near sideline to turn the ball over.
But as you've described the last couple times down the floor, one, Seahawks are denying Elon the position on the floor that they want, and everything, the pass, the shot, the rebound, is now being contested.
Everything is sharper right now for UNCW, down by 11. Near sideline, Burford nearly stepped out of bounds trying to drive. 12 on the shot clock, gets it away to McIntosh between the circles. McIntosh, Burford, he'll take a three from the wing and he'll connect. Boy, he's playing some good basketball right now. 15 first half points for the freshman out of Illinois. Makes it 40-26. Elon's lead is 14.
And funny going into tournament play, sometimes all you need is somebody to get hot and carry you.
Another slip with the screen and the feed Harvey to Pridgen, who banks it in once again. So that's been a nice combination. It's been Burford, the points for Elon, and Pridgen, the points for UNCW.
You know, Pridgen missed that open shot to start the game. I don't know if he has missed since.
All that, everything else has been kind of driving to the basket rather than settling for the jump shot for Pridgen. Jump shot here, in and out. No good for Burford. Rebound for Pridgen. Pridgen pushes it, bounces it now to Harvey. Backs it away to Okaru. 40-28, UNCW trails, 3:45 until halftime. Boggs top of the key, left wing Gadsden. Out front now Pridgen. Pridgen will drive, bounces it out to Okaru. Three on the way, halfway down, popped out into the hands of Nduba. Quickly, they get it to McIntosh. Three in the corner. That's no good. Harvey comes away with it for UNCW. The Seahawks going left to right. He'll slow it down. Will Harvey.
Seahawks more than holding their own right now at the defensive board. It's one and done for Elon.
Harvey off to Okaru. Okaru will drive into traffic, leans in against McIntosh with those two fouls. No good with the shot. Rebound for the Phoenix. 40 to 28, a 12-point lead. Woods down low to Hannah. Blocked away by Pridgen. Saved it. Did Gadsden to Pridgen, and Gadsden gets it back. What a half for Pridgen right now for UNCW. Left corner, Boggs. Tried to get a three off, but right there was McIntosh.
Seahawks spread the floor.
Hand off to Harvey. Out front, Boggs. He's open for a three, and it rattles home. First points of the game for the sophomore, Jake Boggs, and the Seahawks get the lead for Elon under double digits. It's 40 to 31, 2:24 to go in the first half. McIntosh, trap comes, passes out of it to Woods. Woods, jump shot at the free throw line is no good. Another rebound for Pridgen. Bounce pass near sideline. Harvey steps through. Blocked away by Woods, out of bounds. Last touch by Elon. It'll stay with UNCW. They'll have it after immediate timeout. The Seahawks once down 23, down just 9. 40 to 31, 2:09 to go in the half. Back in a moment, it's UNCW basketball on Flow Sports and the Breeze.
As media and advertising continues to evolve, your business advertising needs to evolve with it. Sunrise Broadcasting will help you coordinate between all the different media platforms and deliver a hyper-effective, brand-building, customer-generating program all in one. Sunrise Broadcasting, your one-stop shop for results. For information, call General Manager Valerie Brooks at 910-632-2114.
Again.
910-632-2114.
There is something indescribably special about this place. The way it looks, the way it feels, the way we care for one another and our community. The University of North Carolina Wilmington is like no other. You can't know someone has COVID-19 just by looking at them. Anyone can get it. But while you can't know who is carrying the virus, you should know that everyone who wears a mask has a reason to fight it. Whatever your reason, get behind the mask.
Kennedy's Real Estate Services wants to help you with your real estate needs. Tim Kennedy has been your friendly neighbor for years, serving New Hanover, Pender, and Brunswick counties since 1994. Tim is a full-service broker which can help you find a home or sell your home, management services such as association management as well as long-term rentals. He is also a state-certified appraiser. He's on the web at CANADYRES.com or give him a call at 799-1068.
Until halftime, UNCW trails by 9, 40-31. Mike McCarroll, Marty here with you. Robert Warren, Teleproductions crew. Robert's back at the Breeze studio as well. And fans in the stands here inside Trask Coliseum. Rob Brickle, shouldn't he be working right now?
Brickle's working? He should be here. 14-3 run for the Seahawks.
Top of the key, it's Gadsden moving it left, will push off. No foul call there. Pridgen, the hot hand for UNCW, drives, kicks it out to Phillips. Phillips backs it away to Okaru. 9 on the shot clock for UNCW. Goes left, spots up. 3, too hard. Boggs the battle for the basketball, but he pushed Burford trying to come up with it. And for Boggs, his first in UNCW's fifth. Nobody in foul trouble for UNCW. It's 5 fouls on 5 different Seahawks so far here in the first half.
So, Mike, we've talked about the defensive effort right now for UNCW. It's a scoring drought over 255 for Elon, and they are 1 for their last 9 field goal attempts.
Defense has really picked up Woods near sideline. Trap comes, passes out of it, and throws it away. Pridgen ahead to Phillips. Phillips drives in. Phillips leans in, blocking foul, and will get to the free throw line. The Seahawks doing a great job attacking here. They've got 14 points in the paint. You can look out there. There's not really any bigs, so it's the guards with their penetration making things happen right now for UNCW.
And as you can see, the team's just getting a lot more comfortable right there. There's the block and now the free throws. But all of a sudden, you mentioned the double team. All of a sudden, they're trapping. You can see the energy, the more confidence. It's almost like UNCW had to spot Elon maybe the first 8 minutes of this game just to get the legs in. And since then, it has really been the Seahawks that have taken the action.
Second free throw for Phillips is no good. That foul, meanwhile, was on McIntosh, his third. And he'll sit with 1:24 left in this first half. Seahawks trailing 40-32. Down just eight now. Woods down the floor. Burford far sideline. He'll drive it in. And the layup is good for Darius Burford. 17 first half points. He had 13 total points Monday at William & Mary. 42-32, back to a double-digit lead as Boggs has top of the key. Low pass to Gadsden under a minute until halftime. Pridgett, near sideline, Phillips. Stutter dribble, drives in, spins back. He's stuck, he'll flip it up over his right shoulder and connects.
How important, big picture, are these minutes for Phillips?
Really important here for him. Again, he's been out all year long. And getting his first minutes in this game. He's got 4 points coming off the bench. 42-34, UNCW back to within 8 points. A little push off for Burford. Near sideline, Wooten. Backs it away, Naduba. Get it at the high post to Hannah. Back to Naduba, seven on the shot clock. Naduba spots up straight on three. Boy, good shot there because he had a hand in his face. Right there was Boggs, but Naduba able to connect. Makes it 45-34, 10 seconds until halftime. Okaru in the center jump circle. Angles it left, 4 seconds, 3 seconds, three on the way, back iron no good, rebound Woods, and that is the end of the first half. So UNCW down by 23 early in the half. They have recovered, they've got things going here, getting some good minutes from Joe Pridgen, who leads them with 13. The Seahawks down 11. 45-34 our score at halftime, but it's 20-16. Your local Sherwin-Williams paint store has quality paint, paint supplies, and stains to bring your ideas to life. Painting questions, ask Sherwin-Williams.
So, Mike, one number you always want to see, especially if you're the home team, you want to go to the free throw stripe more than the opponent. Seahawks have been there 12 times, Elon but once. Turnover.
Knocked away by the defense. It'll stay with UNCW as the Seahawks start the second half with the basketball down 45-34. Same five that started the game on the floor for UNCW. That's Gadsden, Pridgen, Boggs, Harvey and Okaru. McIntosh will start the second half for Elon despite having three personal fouls. So they stick with their same five. Naduba, Burford, Hannah, and Wright went down hard early in the first half. Okaru drives, kicks it right corner to Gadsden. Three connects, does tie Gadsden. So Gadsden gets the scoring started in the second half, and the Seahawks down just 45-37 now. An 8-point lead for Elon.
There's that trap.
Naduba gets it to the right wing. Backs it away to McIntosh. UNCW man-to-man. The left elbow, it's Hannah. Left corner, Burford. Burford on the drive with a dribble. Spins back, gives it off to McIntosh. Eight on the shot clock, McIntosh. Burford, near sideline, Naduba. Back to Burford. Shot fake, he'll drive back to Naduba with one on the shot clock. The three is short, tracked down by Harvey. The Seahawks look to push it. Harvey will drive. Harvey will kick it to Gadsden. Another three, this time short. And Simon Wright climbs the ladder to get the rebound for the Phoenix. 45-37, an 8-point Elon advantage. Wright, top of the key, holding it high, gets it inside to Hannah. He's the pivot man in this offense. Kicks it out near sideline. The three is no good for Naduba. Rebound against him. The pitch ahead to Okaru. Underhands to Pridgen. Back to Okaru. Boy, that was just out of sync from the start as it goes through Okaru's legs and out of bounds on the near sideline. So 45-37. right. And get it into McIntosh after the turnover for UNCW, their fifth. McIntosh spots up, three on the way, a short long rebound. Nobody boxed him out, he gets his miss. Near sideline to Burford. Oh, fakes a shot, spins back, flips it up with his right hand and connects.
So the coaching staff will not be happy with that. They got Elon to take a long shot, but nobody picked him up, and they got the offensive rebound, and it led to a quality possession.
Okaru getting a screen from Boggs, goes right and is fouled out front. And that'll leave for the shot. Foul on Simon Wright.
Isn't it interesting how this game has just settled down? All of a sudden, it's you get the feeling it's a normal flow of a college basketball game.
After it looked like Elon was going to come out to a 40-point win the way this game started, up 23 early in this contest.
Looked like a scrimmage at the beginning.
So again, UNCW 27-day layoff, the second time they've had 27 days in between games this season. Pridgen top of the key, spots up three straight on, and it's good. It's not become his shot, Pridgen. It's more of a driver, but he knocks in his sixth three of the season, makes it 47-40, and the Seahawks to within 7 points. 17-23 to go in the second half.
Closest they've been, remember, it was an 11-0 run in the first 3 minutes to open this game.
Wright could not answer from three. A battle for the basketball. Phillips pushed by Hannah, but it's going to be a foul on Shaikeem Phillips. The second on Phillips, the first on UNCW in this half.
So you see Phillips go down, but he grabbed the wrist. Basically had Elon's defender, offensive player, playing with one hand. That's what the officials call it.
And McIntosh, another miss, but another rebound of his miss, and this time he'll hit the shot in the paint. So twice he's missed from long range, but twice he's gotten the offensive board. 49-40, UNCW down by 9, 16:57 in the second half. Gadsden penetrates with the left hand all the way to the basket, off the glass and through. Ty Gadsden, he's got 5 in the second half, and the Seahawks again to within 7. Deflected pass to Ndubu against some pressure in the backcourt. Bounces it to McIntosh. Elon setting it up. McIntosh gets a couple of screens out high. Moves right, spins, fades, flips it, scores it. Hunter McIntosh. He's got 13, makes it 51-42, a 9-point lead for Elon. Harvey drives. Harvey in the right corner to Phillips. Phillips penetrates. Phillips flips it up with the left hand. He'll connect and get fouled by Wright as well.
I'll tell you, for someone that hasn't played at all this year, one, he's making some great moves, and two, he's hit the floor at least a half a dozen times and bounced right back.
I mean, it has been nearly a year since Phillips last took to the court. Did so in Washington, D.C., in that first-round CAA tournament loss last year to Drexel. Out with an injury and was scheduled to come back. And these two teams were initially scheduled to play in early February. Line drive free throw is good for Shaikeem Phillips. UNCW to within 6, down 51-45. They've made their last three field goal attempts as UNCW. Almost 4 minutes into the second half. The right elbow, it's Hannah. Backs it away to McIntosh. McIntosh spots up from 15, fading away. No good, long rebound of Pridgen. Keeps it away from the defense, right side. Boggs, Spoggs, three, banks it in. He said, I'll take it. I didn't mean it, but I'll take it. And the Seahawks to within 3, down 51-48, 15-42 to go in the second half.
Who would have thought this would be a one-possession game after how it started?
Baseline knocked away, out of bounds, last touch by UNCW as we head to our Reeves Jewelers timeout. The Seahawks, a great start to the half, outscoring Elon 14-6. Again, once down 23, now down only 3. 51-48, 15:34 to go. UNCW basketball on Flow Sports and the Breeze.
Christopher Branco of Oleander Chiropractic wants you to know that you don't have to be a UNCW athlete to be treated like one. Stop by Oleander Chiropractic on Oleander Drive in the Arboretum behind Fort City Java, and you'll get the best care in a safe, comfortable family atmosphere. Dr. Branco has 15 years experience and is the official chiropractic consultant of UNCW Athletics. Oleander Chiropractic is open Monday through Friday with morning and evening appointments available. Most insurances accepted. For help, tips, and coupons, visit OleanderChiropractic.com.
From sporty SUVs to rugged and dependable trucks, the Ford lineup has something for everyone, and Capital Ford makes it easy to find the right one for you. Shop online at CapitalFordOfWilmington.com. That's CapitalFordOfWilmington.com, where you'll find over 2,000 new and used vehicles to choose from. You can fill out a finance application, get a quote for your trade, and even complete your purchase completely online. Or come see us on Oleander Drive. And remember, if you buy anywhere else, you'll pay too much.
All-Star Flags is the Cape Fear source for all of your flag-related needs with high-quality, American-made flags and poles. We also specialize in custom flags and banners, including the championship banners hanging within Trask Coliseum. All-Star Flags offers full-service installation on flagpoles, both residential and commercial. Visit our showroom and browse through our selection of U.S., state, military, sports, and international flags. Or check us out online at allstarflags.com. All-Star Flags, quality in every star.
Short on cash? Have unwanted gold or silver? Bring it to Pawn USA. We're North Carolina's premier gold and silver buyer since 1980. Pawn USA will give you the best price in town on your gold, silver, or jewelry. You'll also save money on our wide selection of merchandise, including jewelry, electronics, tools, guns, musical instruments, and more. Don't forget, we cash payroll and income tax refund checks and have millions to lend for most items of value. Don't let life get you down. Get the money you need when you need it at Pawn USA, where the customer is always treated like family and the service speaks for itself.
Down low, Elon nearly turns it over as they get it to Graham in traffic. Hook shot short at the baseline. A rebound for Phillips and the Seahawks down 11. A chance potentially to tie this game. The lob to Okoro. Banks it in from the left side on the feed from Phillips and the Seahawks down just one now. 51-50 and they'll press. In the backcourt, Woods over the stripe. Burford will drive in. Hangs blocked away by Amaje Dodd. Off to Okoro. Bounce pass Gadsden. Gadsden flips it up and in, and the Seahawks lead it 52-51.
Great effort.
14:49 to go here in the second half, and UNCW has their first lead of this ball game.
So who has the quick step right now? You can just see it on the floor. Elon playing flat-footed. Seahawks contesting everything at both ends.
Naduba, 10 on the shot clock. He'll drive in, and the shot is good. Well contested by both Phillips and Dodd that time. 53-52, Elon leads by one. 14:22 to go. Inside the zone, they get it to Pridgen. Pridgen up and under. Pridgen shot. Count it, and he's fouled.
Take another look at it. Good entry pass. Understood where the defenders were coming from. Use that big body. There's that little twist. Tuck it underneath. Mike, remember at the beginning of the game, we said if the game was played in the 60s, the low 60s, it would help Elon. Well, this game's heading into the 70s, and that's definitely where UNCW wants to play it. And you made mention early how surprised in many ways that you were that Elon was pushing it. Well, I don't know if they've run out of gas a little bit right now.
55-53 as Pridgen converts. He's got 19, ties his career high. Near sideline, Burford backs it away to Naduba. UNCW man-to-man. They get it to Graham. Far sideline, three on the way, is good in the corner. And that is Chris Wooten. He had a three in the first half. A big three here makes it 56-55. Elon leads by one, 13:51 to go in the second. Phillips at the point guard position here, puts Okoro to the off guard. As Pridgen gets a near sideline, drives it in and nearly traveled, or it's going to be a held ball, and Elon will get the ball with 13:40 left.
Well, that time he put the ball on the floor a good way away from the basket, and that drew the defenders, and that led to the jump ball, the held ball.
Gadsden out, Harvey back on the floor for UNCW. The Seahawks down by one. Elon going left to right in the second half. Naduba, far sideline, breaks some pressure, drives it in, lobs it up, and Graham will bank it in.
So that's really one of the first times in the second half, especially, that Elon was able to break that pressure, get numbers, use that size advantage underneath on the back end.
58-55, Elon. Dodd to Harvey. Runs into Graham, or Graham runs into him, puts him to the deck, and that's going to be the second personal foul on Michael Graham, the fourth team foul on Elon here in this second frame. UNCW 7-for-7. In their last seven shots, they've made every one. Trying to add to it here. Okaru, three on the way, is all net for Mike Okaru. He's in double figures now with 10 points. The 12th time this season Okaru's been in double digits. And the Seahawks tied up 58 apiece, 12:56 to go. Naduba drives in. Naduba off the glass. That's good, and he's fouled as well.
But you know what's interesting right now? You can see it even with Elon's doing a lot of one-on-one. You mentioned they kind of run that Princeton offense a lot with the half-court back cuts. Well, we haven't really seen that in the last 10 minutes right now, and I still think this style of play, how the game is being played, favors how UNCW wants to close this night.
Naduba, 9 points. Again, played 94 games at Bryant. Injured 2018-19. Graduate transfer as he comes up short. Ball out of bounds. Last touch by Elon. And UNCW will get it back down by two. Gadsden and Boggs on the floor. Phillips and Don will exit.
Interestingly enough, Gadsden has not had a chance to go to the free throw stripe.
That record out there for him if he gets a chance at some point in this ball game. As Gadsden near sideline to Okaru, drives it in. Okaru attacks and he dunks it through right on Graham. Boy, was that athletic move from Mike Okaru. Ties it up at 60.
Send a message.
12:25 to go, and message received by Mike Schrage. Elon head coach wants a timeout. Joe Pridgen can't believe what he just saw from his teammate Mike Okaru as we'll head to a break. This senior does not want to go quietly here tonight on his senior night. Again, 60 all our score, 12:24 to go. Mike Okaru, big time dunk right there, posterizing Michael Graham. Back in a moment, UNCW basketball, Flow Sports, and the Breeze.
Ice cold Bud Light, seltzer here. Bay windows, got two. Nice tuck pointing here. Retractable awning here, like it. Got the nice edging on the grass here. Edge the grass nice here. Ice cold Bud Light, seltzer here. Got a white breasted nut hatch here. Get your ice cold Bud Light, seltzer here. Bay windows, got two. Nice tuck pointing here. Retractable awning here, like it. Got the nice edging on the grass here. Edge the grass nice here. Ice cold Bud Light, seltzer here. Got a white breasted nut hatch here.
Hampton Inn University and Hampton Inn and Suites Landfall Park are proud UNCW Seahawks sponsors. Award-winning hotels providing rooms, suites, catering, and meeting rooms. Ask for the Seahawks special. Call 910-509-0005. That's 910-509-0005 or HamptonInn.com and support the Seahawks.
It's bow time.
Around here, if it's worth doing, it's worth doing right. Like the new Bo's Chicken Sandwich. We're talking massive, juicy chicken breasts tumbled in bold and golden hand breading and served up with punchy, thick-cut pickles, tangy mayo, and toasted buttered buns. Sure, there's a few shortcuts out there, but the right way just tastes better. Try the all-new Bo's Chicken Sandwich for $3.99 only at Bojangles.
It's bow time.
Tied at 60, 12:22 to go. Elon's basketball coming out of the timeout. Hannah near sideline, Naduba backs it away. McIntosh, shot fake, drives it left. Nine on the shot clock, fades away and connects, does Hunter McIntosh. 15 points for the sophomore, last year's rookie of the year and preseason second team all-conference member.
That was a nice shot. The only way he gets that shot off without it being blocked is that fadeaway. Able to execute it, Elon plus two.
Harvey, right side. They get it to Okoro. The Seahawks have made their last nine shots. Near sideline, Gaston, three on the way. No good, but he's fouled by Naduba, who knocks him down. He'll have three free throws coming up on that foul. And we'll see Gaston to the stripe for the first time when we return here after a media timeout. 11:45 to go. UNCW down 62-60. UNCW basketball on Flow Sports and the Breeze.
As media and advertising continues to evolve, your business advertising needs to evolve with it. Sunrise Broadcasting will help you coordinate between all the different media platforms and deliver a hyper-effective, brand-building, customer-generating program all in one. Sunrise Broadcasting, your one-stop shop for results. For information, call General Manager Valerie Brooks at 910-632-2114.
Again.
910-632-2114.
There is something indescribably special about this place. The way it looks, the way it feels, the way we care for one another and our community. The University of North Carolina Wilmington is like no other.
You can't know someone has COVID-19 just by looking at them. Anyone can get it. But while you can't know who is carrying the virus, you should know that everyone who wears a mask has a reason to fight it. Whatever your reason, get behind the mask.
Okay. She's the one, and you know it. At Reeds.com, we're making it easy to find the perfect ring from home. With helpful advice from our online jewelry experts, safe and discreet shipping, and beautiful ring packaging, you'll be confident the moment will be as perfect for her as she is for you. As a trusted jeweler for over 70 years, Reed's Jewelers will be here to make both of you feel like family. Long after she says yes.
11:45 to go. UNCW down 62-60. Great shot from the goal cam of that big dunk by Mike Okoro. So bring it back here. Three free throws coming up for Ty Gadsden, the senior from Charlotte. Eyes the rim. The free throw is up, and it is good. So
27 days between free throws. Can't ice this guy, can you?
27 days for this team to be off. And for Gadsden, setting a CAA record right there. I'll let you know more about it in just a moment as he ties the game at 62. One more free throw up and good. So a new record in the conference for Ty Gadsden, making now 47 straight free throws, breaking the record set by Willie Taylor from VCU back in the 2001-02 season. More importantly in this game, he gives UNCW the lead, 63-62, and now a foul out front. Harvey, his second, team's third. So Ty Gadsden, he had some time to look at that rim, stare at it, and again, give him credit for not getting to that free throw line since January 31st, and Conley knocking in three straight. Near sideline, Naduba spots up. The shot is an air ball rebounded by Harvey. 11:20 to go. UNCW up by one with the ball back. Harvey kicks it out to Okoro. Okoro, long three. Okoro, the shot, no good. Falls off to the right side. Woods, the rebound for Elon. Brings it down to the right wing. Angles it left. Woods gets it back. Drives it right into traffic. Flips up a shot, and he banks it in with the left hand. Boy, that was almost an afterthought by Hunter Woods, but able to connect and give Elon the lead now. 64-63, the score with 10:47 left.
It was like that box three-pointer off glass. I'll take it.
Near sideline, Gadsden. Gadsden drives in. Gadsden the pass to Okoro. Extra pass, Harvey. Feet set, three. It's going to be short, long rebound, Naduba. 64-63, UNCW down by one. McIntosh, three is no good. Long rebound, Gadsden. Gadsden driving in. Gadsden all the way up the glass, short. Naduba the rebound. And Naduba brings it down near sideline for Elon. No numbers. Gets it away to McIntosh. He's open for three. That's short. Pogs the rebound for UNCW. So both teams a little cold right now. 64-63. A one-point lead for Elon as we near the 10-minute mark of the second half inside Trask Coliseum. The final game of the regular season in the conference before the conference tournament kicks off in Harrisonburg, Virginia next week. On Saturday will be the first round games. Okaru, the lob to Pridgen in traffic, gets it away to Harvey. Harvey, three is no good. Pridgen was calling for it. He thought it looked good from his vantage point.
Last three times down the floor, the Phoenix have put the ball up so quickly. See if they take more time and try to run the offense.
Hunter Woods, shot fake, moves it left with the dribble. Drive, spins back. Off now to Naduba. Naduba loses it, and last touch by UNCW. Over the end line, it'll stay with Elon. 11 on the shot clock, 9:23 on the game clock. So UNCW, it made nine straight field goals, but now have missed their last four, scoring drought of more than 2 minutes. Three on the way is no good for Woods, and a rebound out front for Okaru and UNCW. Seahawks down one with the ball back. Okaru gets it to the trailer. Boggs out front now to Phillips, back on the floor. Shaquem Phillips, hand off to Okaru. Boggs top of the key, three over Hannah, no good. And it's McIntosh the board for the Elon Phoenix.
See if they put the ball in both her hands. They don't.
No, all the way goes McIntosh. 17 now for the sophomore. Okaru the other way trying to answer, leans in. Off balance shot is no good, and McIntosh the rebound. 66-63, Elon leads by three. Burford here, and off balance lean in shot connects. 21 now for the freshman, makes it 68-63. And DeKeo Siddle will call a timeout here with 8:29 to go. He sees Elon on a run, a 6-0 run for the Phoenix right now. And the Seahawks, boy, the shots have been tougher driving in, trying to get some contact. They're just not getting those whistles right now and not getting those shots to drop either. Marty, they trail by five as we keep things here.
Little helter-skelter the last 3 minutes. Both teams really taking shots very quickly. Seahawks trying to force some contact, not getting calls. Officials letting them play a little bit. Only three team fouls for UNCW, five for the Phoenix. So neither team in the penalty as we go down the stretch. And, you know, it has been a strange season, obviously. You know, you talk about all things considered, you want things even. But if you look at it, Delaware and Elon have played the fewest total games this year. UNCW will close the year having played the least conference games. So you not only can you not compare schedules or records, you also have to look at, well, when did you pause? When did you pause? Who's playing at the end? Not who's playing well, but who's playing at the end? And then if you're playing well, that's a bonus next week.
Yeah, Elon's been on pause twice. They've had six games canceled. That's been a couple of guaranteed games for them against both Duke and North Carolina. They've had seven games postponed due to COVID issues as well. And they've had 27 days in between games in conference play as well, just like UNCW. So, everybody has dealt with it at some point during the season. For UNCW, unfortunately, it has caught up to them in conference play. And as we said, this is just the seventh conference game. If seeding were a factor, UNCW would actually get what they call a virtual loss to get them to eight games in conference play. Unfortunately for the Seahawks, that's not going to factor in because they're the 10th seed no matter what. So as of right now, as it looks like, UNCW the 10th seed. They'll play the 7th seed, William & Mary. That game in the first round will be next Saturday at 7 o'clock. 6:45 will be our airtime. But with several teams in the league currently on pause, how does that affect them playing in the conference tournament next week? We don't know. So we'll wait and see if there's any announcements to be made during the week heading into the CAA tournament again, which will start in Harrisonburg, Virginia on Saturday. As you take a look at some of our updated stats, both teams 51% shooting here in this game. Incredible to see UNCW get that high when they start 0-for in this contest and were down by as much as 23. Their largest lead for UNCW has been 2.
This is a big possession coming out of the timeout.
Seahawks down by 5, 8:20 and counting. Phillips driving in, spinning back, fading away from 10 and connecting. Shaquem Phillips, he's got all 9 bench points tonight, and the Seahawks down 68-65 at 8:05 left in the second.
Another good timeout by Takeo. You got the feeling he just settled the group down.
Woods near sideline, out front now to McIntosh between the circles. Man-to-man for UNCW. Bounce pass to right. 9 on the shot clock for Elon. Out front, McIntosh. McIntosh, top of the key, goes left. Fadeaway shot, and it's a wedgie. Wedged in between the backboard and the rim, and the Seahawks will get it with the possession arrow pointing down to their side of the floor. So UNCW gets the bucket from Phillips out of the timeout. And now they get the ball back to Santa Chaos Siddle, dealing with so much this year as a rookie head coach, but dealing with it pretty well right now. 68-65, driving in. Phillips, the bank is too hard this time for Shaquem Phillips. Rebound brought away by Wooten. Near sideline to McIntosh. Harvey tracking him. McIntosh to the far sideline, top of the key, Burford. Burford, and he's bumped by Dodd. Maje Dodd whistled for foul number 3, the fourth team foul. Both teams with 2 timeouts remaining here, 7:11 left, 68-65, a 3-point lead for that man, Mike Strongy's Elon Phoenix squad. It's so hard, Marty, to really evaluate these programs, as you said, across the country this year with everything that's happened and any momentum that you had is zapped away once your team goes on pause.
It really does. And, you know, we talk about the CAA tournament. It'll be interesting once conferences throughout the country begin play, what shakes out.
Right in the corner, up the sideline out of McIntosh.
And what do you do with that large base for some of these major conferences?
So tough to analyze here this year as McIntosh, the 3 is no good. Ball tipped up, tracked down by Gadsden. Seahawks down by 3 with the basketball going right to left. The trailer, Pridgen, trying to drive on it. Right, flips up a shot, it's off the mark. He gets his miss though. Bank wouldn't go. Ball still loose, and in traffic, Pridgen and Wright trying to come up with the basketball. They're going to say it's a held ball, and this time it'll be Elon's basketball. With the possession arrow pointing to their side of the floor. As we get a look at our Logan Holmes replay. And a little bit off the mark here is Pridgen. Leads his team with 19 points. How about this? Jack Martin. So he gets put on the roster. He's in uniform, but yet his managerial duties continue as he is on the floor right now helping clean up the perspiration on the court. We're hoping to see him on the court in a different role at some point in this ball game, but hey, those duties never end, even with that jersey on, buddy.
Well, they said he'd be on the court today.
Exactly.
There's his first court appearance.
But great job by him, and nice reward on senior night. He's a senior manager to have that jersey and be wearing it. Number 44, he said, in honor of Pistol Pete Maravich. Shot no good for Burford, but Elon gets it back. The 3 wouldn't drop for Woods, and the Seahawks get the rebound this time, down by 3. 68-65. I'm just amazed that a senior in college knows who the heck Pistol Pete Maravich is. Nice feed on the drive and the bucket for Joe Pridgen, a career best 21 tonight. Topping the 19 he had against Norfolk State earlier this year. 68-67, UNCW trails by just 1. Burford on the right side, kicks it out to Wooten. Wooten 3, rattles home. Chris Wooten, 3 field goals, all from long range. A junior from Kinston makes it 71-67, a 4-point Elon lead, 5:42 left. Dodd, top of the key, near sideline of Harvey. Bounce pass, Pridgen. They were looking back door for Dodd. They couldn't quite get it there. Instead, Okaro deflected pass out of bounds. Last touch by Gadsden. I think if he leaves that go, Marty, that's going to be last touch off of one of the Elon players. But instead, Elon will get the ball back.
So, tough turnover that time. Empty possession. So, Elon up by 4 right now. Seahawks make a couple substitutions.
Pridgen, Okaru, Gadsden, Harvey, and Phillips, a 5 for UNCW, trailing by 4. McIntosh against pressure in the backcourt. Gets it to Wooten, right back in the hands of McIntosh, and they'll set it up Here in the half court, man-to-man for UNCW. Far sideline, Burford gets a screen from right and rolls to the basket. Burford drives, spins, nowhere to go. At 9 on the shot clock, he'll back it away to Wooten. Taps his nose with his left hand, drives it left. Off-balance shot, short, long rebound, Okaru. Good defense for UNCW. Ahead to Gadsden, three in transition is good for Ty Gadsden.
Sometimes you can just tell once he releases the ball, he knows if it's going in. 1 point game, there's your trap.
Gadsden now with 17. The Seahawks, as Marty said, within one, 4:40 left. They trap again over to McIntosh. It's a 10-second violation. So great defense for UNCW as Takeo Siddle helped out there. Made sure the officials knew that was coming, and a turnover, a big one here for Elon, getting it back to the Seahawks with a chance to take the lead, 4:38 left in the second.
And I think that started as soon as the ball was inbounded. Elon, I think, was caught a little bit by surprise by the trap, took their time, and all of a sudden, by the time they got to midfloor, it was 10 seconds.
Gadsden, near sideline, out front to Okaru on the right wing, into the hands of Harvey. Backs it away to Pridgen. To Phillips, five on the shot clock for UNCW. Phillips, three, now two, spins, shot is up, short. And a rebound in the hands of Elon and Ikenna Naduba. 71-70, Elon leads by one. 4:07 until the end of regulation here inside Trask Coliseum. Right, moves it left, gets it off to Woods. Woods fades away. Back Geyer, no good. Okaro, the rebound for UNCW. The Seahawks have tied it on the glass. Both teams with 32 rebounds. That was our defensive key. Logan Holmes' key of the game to start this broadcast. And the Seahawks have done a nice job here in this game. Harvey to Okaro. Seahawks a chance to take the lead once again, down by one. Phillips drives in. He wants the lead. Banks it in. Phillips in double figures playing for the first time this season. Gives UNCW a one-point advantage, 72-71, 3:24 left in the second. Burford bounces it to Naduba. Wright wants it, gets it at the elbow. Knocked away, recovers, now knocked away again, stolen by Okaro, and he's fouled by McIntosh, and that'll be the fourth personal foul on Hunter McIntosh. Sixth team foul, and bring us to another media timeout. 3:10 to go inside Trask Coliseum. The Seahawks with the lead and the ball back when we return. 72-70 is your score, thanks to that man, Shaikeem Phillips. UNCW Basketball, Flow Sports, and the Breeze.
Randy 612 writes, if you like boneless wings, you dirty. Thanks for the input, Rand Man. But B-Dubs completely reinvented their boneless wings. First, they packed it with so much meat, vegans are writing letters, and I've got the meat sweats. Then they marinated them until they're so juicy it doesn't make sense anymore. Hey, poster boy, your basement isn't going anywhere. So get to B-Dubs for the new boneless wings. Buffalo Wild Wings. Roar!
Kennedy's Real Estate Services wants to help you with your real estate needs. Tim Kennedy has been your friendly neighbor for years, serving New Hanover, Pender, and Brunswick counties since 1994. Tim is a full-service broker which can help you find a home or sell your home, management services such as association management as well as long-term rentals. He is also a state-certified appraiser. He's on the web at CANADYRES.com or give him a call at 799-1068.
From sporty SUVs to rugged and dependable trucks, the Ford lineup has something for everyone, and Capital Ford makes it easy to find the right one for you. Shop online at CapitalFordOfWilmington.com. That's CapitalFordOfWilmington.com, where you'll find over 2,000 new and used vehicles to choose from. You can fill out a finance application, get a quote for your trade, and even complete your purchase completely online. Or come see us on Oleander Drive. And remember, if you buy anywhere else, you'll pay too much.
3:10 left, second half. UNCW leads 72-71. Time to vote for the All-Star Flags All-Star of the Game. Your choice is right there, Shaquem Phillips, who gives the Seahawks a lead. Michael Caru, Ty Gansen, Joe Pridgen, your others to choose from. Again, follow me at Radio Mike B on Twitter. Vote now. We'll have the answer or the winner of that in the post-game show.
Mike, Elon holding opponents this year to about 42% from the floor. Seahawks at 51% right now, outscoring Elon from the line 11-1.
Out front, Pridgen, 10 on the shot clock. Trying to break down the defense, then loses the handle right to Hannah. So turnover, it gives it back to Elon. UNCW leads 72-71, 2:39 left. McIntosh, bounce pass to Naduba, drives it in. Naduba flips it up short, but fouled by Joe Pridgen. Just the first foul on Pridgen and the fifth team foul. So neither team in the bonus yet, although one more foul for Elon will put UNCW in the bonus. Both teams with two timeouts remaining here. Possession arrow favors UNCW as well. But Naduba going to the free throw line to shoot two and a chance to tie or give Elon the advantage.
This is only the second Phoenix to the line all night.
Yeah, how about that?
This is their third shot overall.
First one is good. Just shows how much they have relied on the three-point shot. 10 of 24 from three-point range for a team that averages less than 8 or around 8 per game, so above the average there.
Yeah, but remember, they came out of the gate 8-for-8 and 3-for-3, respectively, overall and from three-point land. So a lot of their three-point shots have been hurried and been contested, especially in the second half.
Naduba hits them both and gives Elon the advantage. 73-72, UNCW down one with 2:28 to go. Seahawks ball, Phillips out front, Okaru, along with Pridgen, Harvey, and Gadsden on the floor. Pridgen, yep, top of the key, right side of Gadsden. Gadsden back to Pridgen. Pridgen on the block, kicks it out to Okaru. 10 on the shot clock for UNCW. Phillips will reset. Phillips drives. Phillips spins back. Phillips fades away. No good. Rebound to Harvey, but he's over the back. No, it's going to be a foul on McIntosh, I believe, and that will be his fifth foul and foul him out of this ball game. So McIntosh, one of the leaders of this team, last year's rookie of the year, their leading scorer, averages over 15 points a game. He's got 17, but he will sit now with 2:02 to go in this contest.
And Mike, that puts Elon in the penalty. So Harvey will be shooting 1-1. Seahawks with 5 team fouls, still 1 to give.
Free throw is good, the front end. And one more coming up for the freshman out of Fayetteville, Jamari Harvey. Ties the game at 73, 2:02 to go in this second half inside Trask Coliseum. Harvey eyes the rim, the free throw is up and perfect. Breaks the tie, and the Seahawks once again have the advantage, leading it 74-73. They can press now, especially without McIntosh on the floor. One of the ball handlers for Elon, broken by Naduba. He's trapped, gets it away to Wooten, and he needs a timeout here, a quick timeout taken by Elon. As Mike Schrock, you saw his team in some dire straits that time with 1:52 to go. A 30-second timeout. We'll keep things courtside here. Mike Vaccaro, Marty Fuhrer with you. Robert Warren, Teleproductions crew. Dylan Roberts back at the Breeze Studio. It's, boy, this game is going to end a lot different than it began here for UNCW, Marty. And a lot of credit to the resiliency of this team and what Takeo Sito has been able to do with this team this year with the lack of numbers and everything else. But, boy, playing one heck of a game here tonight.
Well, you can see, again, they've bought into what he wants to do. And, you know, we talked about, would there be a carryover from how they closed with Hofstra into this one? I don't know if there's been that much of a carryover, but you want the carryover from tonight into next week because you've seen this team just fight through adversity, stay tough, run the offense, play good, solid defense to get back into this one.
Naduba near sideline. Bounce pass to Hannah. Gets it away on the left wing to Woods. Down low on the left block, Burford. Left corner, Wooten. Out front, Woods. Now to Naduba, to reset. 8 on the shot clock for Elon. Seahawks up by one, driving all the way in. Bank shot good for Naduba. And it is Elon leading it now 75-74 rather, a one-point lead. And this game has gone back and forth here with 11 lead changes. Right side, Harvey will drive. Harvey, Law looking for Gadsden, but it's stolen by Burford, who stepped in front of Gadsden, forced to foul him. The second foul on Gadsden was 16 fouls, so no free throws here for Elon. 1:15 left, 75-74. Elon leads by one.
Yeah, that was a tough pass. You pass it. I don't want to say a lazy pass, but certainly it was telegraphed, and Elon jumped into the passing lane. Now with 1:15 to go, see how they work the possessions.
Naduba on the left wing, man-to-man for UNCW. Burford will drive right. Burford hangs in the air and banks it in. Boy, he's got an uncanny ability to just hang in that air, awkward angle with the body, but still able to connect. Makes it 77-74, and now Takeo Siddle wants a timeout with 57.5 seconds left to try to set up a good play and a good look at the basket. It'll be a 30-second timeout, so both teams will be left with just one full timeout each here on out. But, boy, impressed with Burford. Again, this week's player and rookie of the week, coming off of 27 points he had on Saturday against William & Mary. He had 13 Monday against William & Mary, 23 here in this game tonight.
Well, he just opened the game on fire, doing everything right. And now he's closing the game with a couple of big baskets. You're down by three. You don't need a three-point shot right now. Get a good shot. You've got 57.5 seconds. So if you work the clock right, even if Elon uses almost their full allotment at the offensive end, you can trade two possessions for one. Again, the next foul will put both teams on the free throw stripe.
Harvey will inbound. Phillips, Gadsden, Okaru, and Pridgett. Five on the floor for UNCW, down by 3:55 seconds left. Phillips hands off to Harvey. Between the circles. Now to Gadsden. Gadsden wants to drive in. Gadsden hangs in the air. Count the basket, and he's fouled as well. So there you go, Marty. You didn't need the three. Instead, the penetration leads to points and a chance at a three-point play the hard way here with 45 seconds left.
Good, quick first step. Shields the ball. Feels the contact. And a chance to tie the game.
Foul on Hannah, his second. Team's eighth. 45 seconds left. UNCW trails by one. They try to wipe the ball down. Actually, a spot on the floor underneath. So we had 45 seconds to go. Gadsden, 19 points. And make it an even 20. Has not missed since December 12th at Ole Miss. More importantly, ties the game at 77 with 41 seconds to go. Burford to Naduba, far sideline. Spreading the floor here, man-to-man for UNCW.
14-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Seahawks will get the last possession.
10 on the shot clock. Driving in Naduba, off-balance shot, no good. O'Carroll the rebound, the Seahawks have it with the shot clock off. 17 seconds left. Will they call their final timeout? Both teams have one timeout left. 12 seconds, 11 seconds. We're tied at 77. Seahawks ball going right to left. 8 seconds. O'Carroll right side drives in. Oh, he threw it away. Off to Woods, down the floor. Naduba, 2 seconds, 1 second for the win. Yes! Wooten, the buzzer-beating shot. And it is Elon winning it here in Trask Coliseum, celebrating. Oh, what a way to finish the game of the season, maybe for the conference. The way this game ended, though, will certainly not sit well for UNCW. A tough way, and we'll get a look at it here and see. It looked like he clearly got it off in time. Wooten, the release, and plenty of time on the clock there, and that is how this game will end. Chris Wooten, after an